Okay, we're in part two of Got Budget. Now, those that are just tuning in just this month, last month in October, I did a two-part or started a two-part blog on organizing and setting up a very simple budget for your household. Last month, we talked about a bill escrow and how to set one up. Very simple to do, but you'll see now that I have it actually as a line item in my budget. So this month, on my Everything Organized blog, I'm going to be showing you how to set up a simple budget in Excel. Now, there are many resources that I've included in this month's post that you can read and go out to their website. Most of them are free, but there are a few low-cost ones there. Those can track expenses and do things that a simple Excel spreadsheet cannot do. So check out what is easiest for your family. So let me show you what I have. For all simplicity, I have two paydays listed here. I have the 15th and the end of the month. Now you'll notice here that I have each bill separated out. Of course, there's probably plenty more I've not included. This is just a sample. But you notice in red, I have the Discover card listed. It's a debt. I'm trying to pay it off, let's say. So my monthly payment is going to be $100, as you can see. And then over here in parentheses is $500. That's the balance that I still owe on the Discover after I've paid my $100 minimum payment or payment a month, either one you want to do. So that's why you can keep a really good track of your debt, of what you owe within your monthly budget. Now, secondly, I'm just going to use a couple different markers here to show this, but highlight your budget with different colors so you know what you're doing with the money. For example, let's say I pay a bill, and out of the 15th, the car payment, I can highlight that in orange to show that that money has already been taken out of my checking account on the 15th, and it's a done bill. I've already paid it. But let's say that after I've paid all my bills, the electric bill still hasn't been drafted, or I still haven't received a statement in the mail. What you would do is take another color, and you would highlight that. Now, what I do is take that money that I know I have it, but I don't want to spend it. I don't want to think that it's just there in my checking account needing to be spent. So I take that money and I transfer it to either a savings or a second checking account. That way you know that it's not in your checking account to be spent for other things. And when this bill comes due, I transfer the money back, real simple, and pay the electric bill. But you can see I have two different colors in here for my bill paying. And then you obviously see the red for debt. Now, lastly, don't forget, at the bottom of your Excel spreadsheet, make sure that you total up all your bills for each payday. The object is, of course, not to go above what you bring home a month. Now, I've only included some things here in the bills, so make sure you leave room for savings in your 401k, giving maybe even your kids allowance money, whatever those things are that you pay. Think about them and list them and divide them out by which payday is best for you. I am Lorraine Brock, a professional organizer here in the Dallas area, helping you get everything organized.